It may be easy to spot a physical change, such as ripping a piece of paper or observing an ice cube melting. But how do you know when a chemical change has occurred? When a chemical change occurs, it results in a new substance. You may also observe a reaction. Have you ever wondered why bubbles form when an Alka-Seltzer tablet is dropped into water? Let's try it and see what happens when we place a piece of sodium bicarbonate or Alka-Seltzer into some water in a container. I'm just gonna put some regular water in here. Drop a good hunk of the tablet in, seal it. See what happens. Woo! That was quite the reaction. The tablet fizzed rapidly. The moment the tablet starts dissolving, a chemical reaction occurs, releasing carbon dioxide gas. The pressure built behind the lid and forced it to pop open. So what are indicators of chemical change? This is evidence of chemical reactions. So how many of you out there have ever made slime? I made some the other day by mixing some borax, water, and white glue. As I mixed the materials, I noticed the slime felt cold. There was a drop in temperature, or an endothermic reaction, that occurred when I mixed all of these materials. An endothermic reaction absorbs energy instead of giving off energy. Let's see if we can replicate this phenomena in another way. For this investigation, you'll need a wireless temperature sensor, 3 beakers with 50 milliliters of vinegar, and baking soda. Don't worry if you don't have the beakers. You can use a clear cup and then just use a graduated cylinder to measure out your vinegar. You're also going to need some teaspoons. All right, so it's a really good idea to make sure that you have a tray underneath the beakers because it helps you clean up any mess that might occur. Let's get started. First, I'm going to turn on my wireless temperature sensor. I'm going to place that into the first beaker. You're going to want to click on sensor data, connect your device. I knew it was mine because I can see the ID here, 998. It was the first one here closest to me, so I just click that. And we're going to choose the graph template. I want to make sure I have temperature over time. So we're going to do 3 runs. Each run will be using a different amount of baking soda each time. So let's start with 1/4 teaspoon or 1.2 grams of baking soda. Make sure that I have that nice and smoothed out. And I'm going to click start and then drop in the baking soda. No need to stir around with your thermometer. And we're going to let this run until the data starts to level off or plateau. I've noticed that I have bubbles forming. And there seems to be a good drop in temperature occurring here. That's pretty interesting. Okay, the data is starting to level off, so I'm going to stop recording. And then I'm going to move to the next beaker. For this round, we're going to kick it up a notch and use 1/2 teaspoon or 2.4 grams of baking soda. Get it nice and leveled off. Okay, we're going to click start again to do a second run. And drop in our baking soda. That's interesting. Bubbles seem to come up a little bit higher on that one. Interesting. All right, again, we're going to wait for the data to level out. Almost there. Okay, that looks good. I'm gonna stop. And we're gonna do one more run. Our third run is gonna be using 1 teaspoon or 4.8 grams of baking soda. Move my temperature sensor. Make sure I got a nice heaping teaspoon. Start the third run. And dump it on him. Huh, bubbles came up even higher that time. Starting to see a pattern. Okay, I'm starting to level off. Okay, I'm level off. Now I'm going to stop, and I've completed all three runs. We use different amounts of baking soda in each run. We can use the data from our three runs to see if the amount of baking soda added had any effect on the temperature change of the vinegar. So let's go to our SparkView data. Right now I only see run three. If I want to see all of them at once, I just click on each run and it brings them up. And it's pretty clean here. You can see that there's definitely a pattern. But I also want to name each of these so I understand how much I used in each run as far as the baking soda went. So let's click on this icon on run one, and I can click any data point and the T for the text box. And that allows me to put in how much I used. Move to run two. Just helps you make sure you don't mix up any of the data points. Run three. This was the full teaspoon. And you can move these around however you wish. But now I want to make sure you understand how to see what the starting temperature was and the ending temperature. And we're going to use a coordinate tool for that. So again, I've clicked on run one. That's active. I can click on this data point and the coordinate tool, and it's telling me that I started at 24.0 degrees Celsius. I can click on the end point, same thing, and it's telling me I ended at 22.7. So this is important for you students to know. You're going to be working with negative numbers. Although this isn't a focus for you at the elementary level in mathematics, it's a great way for you to be introduced to the task. Know that you could use a calculator for this if you needed to. The formula that you're going to use is change equals the ending temperature minus the starting temperature. Using your data and observations, did the amount of baking soda used affect the reaction in any way? In this investigation, the drop in temperature was the evidence of a chemical change. But is a drop in temperature always evidence of a chemical change?